Hola and welcome to a new recipe. Today we're gonna recreate blood chicken stew, but with a twist. We don't have any blood. Also known as cabidela in Portuguese, this is a rich, deep, flavorful dish. It's a dish I grew up eating. As I remember as a child going to my grandfather's backyard, he would go kill the chickens, I would hold the container, we'd put the blood in, save all of that, and at the weekend as a family, we'd all come together and eat this fantastic dish. But I have a problem. Where I live, it's nearly impossible, not to say actually impossible, to get chicken blood. But I love this dish so much. What did I do? I found a way to create this dish without any blood. The flavors will be there, but we're just removing the blood and adding different ingredients to recreate that flavor. You can make this dish two ways. It can be with rice or it can be with potatoes. Today we're gonna recreate it with potatoes just because it's my favorite. We're just gonna break it into small pieces so we can brine it and season it a little bit before we start cooking. As a tip, if your chicken still has some feathers, hold on to it. Just grab a bit of paper. Get all of that out. Clean, see? Everything comes out quite easy. Stick to the end, we're gonna have a preview of our next recipe. I'm gonna salt this chicken, garlic paste, and a little bit of lemon juice. Get your hands in and get that all across your chicken. Ideally, we're gonna let it rest for 90 minutes, but 1 hour, if you're short on time, should be enough. Small dice an onion. Gonna use some canned potatoes. Don't be afraid of canned vegetables. They're so easy to use. But the secret for these potatoes, we need to brine them for about an hour so they can get some flavor in. We're gonna start with some lard. I'm using black pig lard, Iberico pork lard. This type of lard from this pig is 10 times superior to all the other lard. We're gonna get this pan nice and hot because what we want now, we want to create some browning in our chicken. And by adding the flour, we're gonna get our sauce in a better consistency at the end. A little bit of olive oil. Onions and garlic go in. Lower the heat. Bay leaf. A little bit of white wine, fish sauce, cayenne pepper, some white pepper, some garlic powder, some onion powder, chicken stock, a vegetable stock. I'm gonna add some water. I'm gonna add the chicken back in the pan and we're gonna fill it up with boiling water. I'm gonna let it cook for 30 minutes. We add the red wine and our balsamic vinegar. And we let it simmer until we reduce our sauce to half. We can see how different the sauce looks now after everything is cooked. Now we're gonna taste to adjust all the seasonings. Oh, it's great. Then add a pinch of sugar to balance the vinegar in the sauce. Touch of white vinegar. We add the potatoes in and we just let it simmer for a couple of minutes for the potatoes to melt into the flavors of the pot. To finish it off, just a drizzle of balsamic, touch of lemon juice, and there we have it, chicken blood stew with no blood. Smells so good. Try the potatoes. Such a comforting dish. First you get hit by the vinegar in the sauce, the acidity of it. Right after, you get all that chicken flavor coming right through. When you add the potato to it, just some nice softness and creaminess to it. It's absolutely heartwarming. Perfect. How easy it was to get here. Everything in one pot. And in the end, we get a really comforting dish that, especially in cold days, is gonna really warm you up inside. Try this dish. Let me know in the comments what you think of it. If you tried it before with the blood, let me know if you feel that the flavor is like spot on with it. It has that acidic punch. It just feels like the same dish, just made differently. So try it. So if you can't find any chicken blood where you live, this is an easy solution for that. So don't deny yourself the chance to try this dish even without the blood. Thank you for joining me today. And for now, I'm just gonna dig in again. See you on the next video. Ciao.